we're gonna have a wrap around. Does he skill E already? He probably shouldn't have anything skilled. There you go. Has the E hook shot away. 100 Thieves bottom lane was able to push that wave all the way to bottom turret and then start heading up the river. They're threatening the roam here. They even find the pick.
Perks is in trouble. Perks is down, and FBI claims first blood.
I'll have one, and FBI is feeling great about it. Now, Cloud9 have crashed a large wave up into the tier one turret. Blabber's going in for the damage, and they go in and get it done. Someday's already down. Cloud9 looking for even more now is who he wants to come up and try to help. Fudge still looking to stay alive here is who he goes underneath the turret. Blabber almost kills him, but almost ain't good enough. Fudge doing the same, barely getting away. Abadaga going to be taken low. Blabber's about to die. Closer gets the kill. Goes for reset number one. Can he find anything? Vulcan's still here at level five.
Rotation up.
Yep, you can see your FTX gold chart right now. It's 300 Thieves players in those top three spots, and they might just get a little bit more. Vulcan loses about half health. The arrow comes flying through, but it will not find a target.
Quite a few outs.
Now he's got the squad.
As well as some
He's also got his buddies. That is the biggest escape tool available. Fudge getting hit there by the flash and the hook shot, both stuck in the Hextech ultimatum. Tries to get away. The oranges keep him alive. There comes your enchanted crystal arrow, so there's no follow-up available really from Huhi. If you can manage to take off this last little bit of HP, you get the plate money for it as well. And thumbs up, there we go. First turret. Cannot do enough damage to kill this turret. They will need a bit of follow-up, as now Closer has found Vulcan in the topside river. Dredge line to get himself away, keeps Vulcan alive. Abadaga coming in. Might be able to find some damage over the wall here. Rune Prison into the Heartbreaker, and Vulcan is down. Closer picking up the kill here. Two for him this game, and 100 Thieves is going even further. Teleport up here in the top lane. Someday's looking to go. Hook shot right back in. Sven with a flash away. Chains of Corruption coming out. Sven's about to go down. Shockwave not going to hit much of anything. 100 Thieves still looking to make the moves. Everybody's falling apart, and Cloud9's got no way out. 100 Thieves just bulldoze them.
Flat lethality, and then adding the extra little bit, these arrows from FBI will just murder people.
And speaking of that murder, look at Vulcan's health bar nearly completely removed, and they force him to flash away.
Even less time to react than versus a normal team. So Hawk shots are just being spammed over and over. There's a hit.
Okay, Blabber getting locked down. He's in some trouble, and that is the first kill. Make it two for 100 Thieves. One of them's the enemy jungler, so it's time for a bit of a Baron play, my friends.
It should look easy. Arrow comes through, and the Hail Mary from Cloud9. Can they get a miracle steal?
Well, they've got the Gangplank ulti here, just pouring some damage into the health bars. Huhi and Closer are both very low, but the Baron is also about to die. FBI's going to take some damage from Zven. Fudge coming in there. Someday's around on the flank. Perks getting the kill onto Huhi, but FBI's able to take down Zven. Closer gets away with 100 HP.
Far away on the Camille, and Cloud9 save it for now.
And GP is so difficult to just commit to Baron to, but they're going for a fight now.
Someday's ready to go in. He finds Fudge. He finds a lot of damage. He goes for the Hextech ultimatum, but now he gets locked down. Fudge is ready to return some damage here. Is he going to have enough? It looks like he does. Someday is out of the picture. Abadaga is about to die next. 100 Thieves are just doing a conga line down mid lane straight to the Death Depot.
Someday.
Closer looking for something else, but he won't find it.
Surging back here. Dragon being burned down as well as they head into the river. Closer looks like he's got moves planned.
Okay, Closer jumps in, finds a bit of damage onto Vulcan, then uses his ulti defensively to get away. Yes, you had the backup damage from FBI, but if Closer kept going in there, he was a dead man.
Muramana transformed. Lethality is in for FBI, so yes,
so
those arrows definitely hurt.
Oh, but over the wall, they're going in after Vulcan here yet again. Blabber could be the target now. Perks losing half HP, but a bunch coming right back into Huhi. First kill goes on to Blabber. FBI's the one to claim it. Can't keep the Varus out of the fight that easily as Abadaga and Closer both backing away.
And see if they can burn it down quick enough. 5,000 health
and counting. No GP ulti.
No GP ulti, no jungler. This is a 100 Thieves Baron that Cloud9 can say nothing about. And it's huge for the tempo and the pace of this game.
Grabbing on Perks.
Perks could be in some trouble, but instead it's back in mid lane. FBI gets caught. Abadaga gets caught. Both of the carries from 100 Thieves have been caught. Gangplank ulti comes down to stop the escape route. Sven flashes forward, puts an arrow in his chest. A double kill for the Cloud9 AD carry.
Last time around, the price was 2,000 gold and a dragon. This one is very close. So, perfect arrow there from Sven, nails FBI, then gets kicked in by Blabber, and it's both carries, 2-for-1 deal, plus the Guardian Angel that Flowers had been pointing out. So whenever you get a kill on one of these fed carries.
Laying down these lines of control wards to keep Cloud9 afraid. Enchanted Crystal Arrows fired off somewhere, but not near enough to any 100 Thieves health bars to really be a problem. Fudge going for a little bit of damage here with the barrels. Leona ulti only gets a slow, no hard CC here.
For this, and you can see them focusing on getting your vision inside, trying to hit one of these skill shots.
Oh, it's a deep DB flank.
Okay, they're ready to go. It's 100 Thieves wanting to make the move, but Cloud9's ready to turn it around and go for the fight here right now. Closer going to be your target. Defensive ulti getting away. Someday coming around from behind. Perk's going to be under pressure. Shockwave able to find one. FBI's going to be taken low, but can they find the kill? No, they cannot. Cloud9's getting run over. FBI's going to be peeled for. Double kill back over to him, and Vulcan's the last man standing. 100 Thieves stand tall!
And for the first time since they created the team in 2018, 100 Thieves are going to be running it back to finals!
They march down mid lane. They make the call for the flank play. Cloud9 responds. They try to face them in open ground first, but 100 Thieves have the outplay. It is a redux. It is a reload of that 2018 Spring Final. 100 Thieves and Team Liquid, we'll see you tomorrow.
What a final fight there by 100 Thieves. The slimmest of margins. Closer, life-stealing off minions, surviving the final tick of Ignite with single-digit health. Abadaga barely surviving. FBI down below 10%. That was a 5-for-0. And what could have gone either way?
What a series here from the 100 Thieves. And they've shown that they have so much more to offer than a single style as well.
Yes.
So many problems that you have to solve when you're facing this team. I think the second time around here versus Team Liquid, the rematch is going to be a different story. This one is going to be hype.
I'm so ready for this. The first split that this organization